Yo, what is good everybody, it is Sam from Antidote Audio and my brand new bass house pack Vortex just dropped. So I'm gonna do a mammoth bass house tutorial to celebrate. This includes six of my top tips for bass house production and a few new things I picked up while creating this sample pack. So first things first, bass note length can actually play a big role in the overall sound of your drop. For example, so with all these bass notes, they end where a new bass note begins. There's no gap whatsoever with any of these bass notes. It's just a consecutive bass noise. Sometimes that works, sometimes maybe not so much. What I found with bass house particularly is to have a little gap before the next note starts can add just even more impact for the next note or something like that. Anyway, Command A or Control A and just Control or Command. I'm gonna grab the end and turn them. I'll actually just loop it and then we'll hear how it sounds. So this sounds way too happy in 2008 electro house. We want this tiny little gap in between. What I just picked up then, some overlaps in bass notes, actually works really sick with this preset. Nah, this note. What's Serum doing? Is that monophonic or legato or what's... It's nothing, it's just overlapping and it sounds sick. Anyway. Yeah, with this pack, you'll find quite a few of the bass notes actually have a little bit of silence before the next bass note starts. It's just a cool little trick. A little bit more, I'm really struggling to find the word for this. It's not impact, it's not really energy, it's more, it sounds cool, all right. Next up is Sidechain. I know many will already know, so if you want to skip to the next one, I've left locator markers in the video. But if you don't know Sidechain already, you really need to know this. It is the most important thing with house and bass house. So with this, the bass and drums are just overlapping, there's no bounce, there's no pop, the kick has no room, and they're just clashing overall. So sidechain compression will fix that and will sound absolutely amazing. Compressor on the bass, this little down arrow here, initiate sidechain. We're gonna turn off EQ, audio input from, oh my god, where is it, 7, the kick. And bring down that threshold. And dial it to taste. So before, after. You can chuck this on effects as well, it doesn't have to just be bass, to give the effects just a bit more pump. Sidechain, so crucial. If there's one thing to take away from this video and you didn't already know what sidechain was, that is the one thing to take away from this video. Standard versus swing, so normal standard, everything. Everything is abiding by the quantization, which is 16ths in this case, but we want a bit more swing, we want a bit more groove, we want to delay the second and fourth 16th notes in our MIDI and our audio and just give it a bit more swing, a bit more groove. In order to do this, you can go into your MIDI and apply swing here. You'll see this little section for groove. We can apply this MIDI rule, which swings out our notes. So click this button here, hot swap mode. I'm gonna go ahead into swing 16ths. I particularly like 57, around 59, 64. You can hear what it's doing to the notes. Bit too much. Let's go for 64. I feel like we need a particularly swingy kind of sound for this to get the point across. And then click X once we're done. So what is it actually doing? So pay attention to this note and this note. So you can just leave it like this, or you can commit the groove with this button here. So before, after. This note is suddenly not on the grid anymore, and same with this note, the second and fourth, that's three. The second and fourth 16th MIDI notes for this particular MIDI. Sounds super swingy. But as long as you have the groove load up, you don't have to commit it to the MIDI, it'll play the swung sound. This doesn't just work on MIDI, this works on audio clips as well. Once we've loaded up a group in our project, you'll see it again here. Click and apply that there, and of course, and other tracks as well. and the shuffle snare. Of course we want it on the shuffle snare. And let's go. So if you want to make your bass house or house track even funkier and groovy, I would definitely recommend playing around with swing on your tracks. Joyride uses it on some elements of the drop, but not others. Like a bass will play normal quantized 16th notes, but the snares in the background will be swung, and it somehow works. So pick up Joyride is what I'm getting at. And onto the fifth, which is technically the fourth tip in this video. I should have made it the fifth tip in this video. Anyway, something magical happens when you just have a bass layer, and then when you add something else on top of it, seven semitones above, which I think is technically the fifth note in a scale. So if we look at this bass stack right here, made up the sub, bass, and a separate layer. This is going to be our fifth, by the way. I've completely stripped out the bass on this one, because in order for this to work, I'm going to absolutely slam it with the other basses, and it's just going to sound super, super good. So if we go into this MIDI of the saw wave, this is going to be our fifth thing, and we're going to bump this up seven semitones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And all together with the basses. If you listen to like Future House, Oliver Heldens in particular does this technique a lot. Yeah, seven semitones is the key to get that sound. That sounds sick. We're gonna absolutely slam it together. A lot of drive on the saturator. Beautiful. If we bump it down, oh fuck, I can't count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. More distortion. I kind of like it when it clips. That sounds so good. Anyway, with the drums. Tip number five, which really should have been four because the fifth could have been fifth. But anyway, regardless, tip number five is the shovel snare. I'll make a separate video on this. It's super, super important just to add extra groove along with the swing of your drop. So no shuffle snare. I've got needed. Good, but could be improved. I'll crank it so you guys can hear it. It's just a little snare that comes in here and there. But the main thing is it's swung as well and it's not playing all the time. It's so groovy and it just works really well with that bass house that's kind of funky instead of hard hitting. So yeah, if you're wondering why your drop isn't as groovy as you want it to be, have you added the shuffle snare? That's the main question. And tip number six is the bass house clap. I didn't realize how easy it is to make a clap for bass house. It is so damn easy. It's just so, so simple, and you can tweak it to whatever sound you want it to be. I'm gonna use operator for this one. You can use whatever synthesizer that creates noise or white noise. So this is our standard sine wave at the moment. We're gonna change that to white noise. Envelope, turn this down. That's gonna be our sound. It sounds like ass at the moment. Don't worry, it gets better. And we're gonna input this wherever our claps would be normally in the track. And we're gonna use the secret ingredient, which is OT, no, it's overdrive. Kind of sounding like bass house now. Kind of getting there. We need another overdrive. There we go, there's the... And there we go, there's the bass house clap. And just to help really glue it in with the drums overall, I'm gonna group the drums together. Saturator. Boom, easy, there's the bass house clap. So, so easy! And those are my six bass house top tips. If you did like the samples I used in this track, they're from my brand new pack, Vortex. Link will be in the description. Bass house construction kits, which is just a whole bunch of stems slash loops for you to use in all your bass house bangers. I use these kits all throughout the tutorial. Hopefully you did learn a thing or two, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace!